Well, somebody has to arrange the matches. Young people can't decide these things for themselves.
She might bring somebody wonderful.
Someone interesting.
And well off.
And important. Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a fine, catch me a catch. Matchmaker, matchmaker, look through your book and make me a perfect match.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, I'll bring the veil. You bring the groom, slender and pale. Bring me a ring, for I'm longing to be the envy of all I see.
For Papa, make him a scholar.
For Mama, make him rich as a king.
For me, well, I wouldn't holler if he were as handsome as anything.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a fine, catch me a catch. Night after night in the dark, I'm alone.
Chava, I thought you just had your eye on your books. And you had your eye on the rabbi's son?
Well, why not? We only have one rabbi, and he only has one son. So why should I want the best?
Because you're a girl from a poor family. So whatever Yenta brings, you'll take, right? Of course, right.
He's 62,
but he's a nice man, a good catch. True, true. I promise you'll be happy, and even if you're not, there's more to life than that. Don't ask me what. From side to side, but he's a nice man, a good cat, right? Right! You heard he has a temper, he'll beat you every night, but only when he's sober, so you're all right. Did you think you'd get a prince? Well, I do the best I can with no dowry.
Up to this minute, I misunderstood that I could get stuck for good.
Dear Yenta, see that he's gentle. Remember, you were also right. It's not that I'm sentimental.
Train, Papa. You'll be late for your customers.
Just a few more minutes.
So, he's in big trouble, this hero of yours. Arrested? And convicted?
Yes, but he did nothing wrong. He cares nothing for himself. Everything he does is for humanity.
If he did nothing wrong, he wouldn't be in trouble.
Papa, how can you say that? What wrongs did Joseph do, or Moses, or Abraham?
And they had troubles.
So why won't you tell me where he is, this Joseph of yours?
It is far, Papa. Terribly far. He's in a settlement. In Siberia.
Siberia? He wants you to leave your father and mother and join him out there in the frozen wasteland and marry him there?
Oh, Papa. He did not ask me to go. I want to go. I don't want him to be alone. I want to help him with his work. It's the greatest work a man can do, Papa.
But, Puddle, baby.
Papa.
Can I hope to make you understand why I do what I do? Why I must travel to a distant land, far from the home I love? Once I was happily content to be as I was, where I was, close to the people who are close to me, here in the home I love. Who could see that a man would come, who would change the shape of my dreams? Watching all the dreams grow dim. Oh, what a melancholy choice this is. Wanting home, wanting him. Closing my heart to every hope but his. Leaving the home I love. There where my heart had settled long ago, I must go, I must go. Who would imagine I'd be wandering so far from the home I love? Yet there with my love I'm home.
But who will be out there to marry in the wilderness?
Papa, I assure you, we'll be married under a canopy.
No doubt a rabbi or two was also arrested out there. I always thought he was a good man. Tell him that I rely on his honor to treat my daughter well. Tell him that.
Oh, Papa. God only knows when we shall see each other again.
And we shall leave it in his hands.
Take care of her. See that she dresses warm.